Welcome back to another 2-minute tutorial where we aim to give you the best tips and tricks for your stream in under 2 minutes. In this video, we're going to be talking about exactly how you can add information from Spotify showing the title, the artist, maybe even the album art of the track that's currently playing so you can display it on your stream and you no longer have to have your viewers asking you what song is playing. By the end of this video, you'll know exactly how to add all of this information into your stream design and overlay, and I'll show you some customization tips so you can change the font style, positioning, and add a scrolling text effect too. Okay, so first thing that we need to do is head to the link at the top of the description to download a super lightweight program called Snip, which is going to allow us to take that information from Spotify and display it on stream using our streaming software, something like OBS or Streamlabs OBS. So click the link at the top of the description. It'll take you to a page like this where you can download the zip file for Snip. One thing I will mention is that Snip has gone through a massive rework in the last 6 months. So the reliability is much better with Spotify detection. So if you've used it in the past before and it hasn't worked out for you, I would encourage you to download it again because, as I say, it's gotten much better in reliability with Spotify. So download the zip and extract it to a folder that you know where it's going to be on your PC. So I'm going to extract mine into a folder I've already created called Snip. And then all we have to do is double click to start running Snip. It will pop up with a web page asking you to log into your Spotify account just so it can connect to the Spotify API. Now, once you've connected your Spotify account to Snip and you have it running, you should see a couple of new files in this folder, one called snip.txt and one called snip_artwork. All we need to do is drag the TXT file into our streaming software. So for me, that's OBS Studio, and onto the scene where we want to display the now playing information. So I drag that, drop it on top, and you can see now I have this text source, which is exactly the song and artist that are playing on Spotify. So if I skip song on Spotify, you should see that also the text updates to reflect the new song and new artist that is playing too. If you want to customize the font or the size or anything like that of the text that's displaying on screen, all you have to do is right click the text source, go to properties, and then in here you can choose a different font style, different font size. I will use something like Monster at semi bold. Click OK and you can see it's now using the new font instead. And of course you can drag this around and position it exactly where you want. If you want to have the text scrolling, because you have a section of your overlay where you want to display this text constantly, all you have to do is right click the text source again, come up to filters and add a scrolling filter to the text effect. So you can just leave this named as scroll. All you have to do is set the horizontal speed to something that you like, something around 25. And then I would recommend using limit width and just playing around with the width limit. This means that if you have a super long title, it's not going to go all the way across your overlay and, you know, hide something that you don't want to be hidden. So I'm going to limit my width to something around 400. And you can see here, there is a little issue where the artist name goes right next to the track name again. So we just need to fix that in the Snip options. So come down to the system tray, right click on Snip and go to set output format. And then here you can see exactly how it displays the track name, what the separator is between the track and artist, and the artist format. So what I like to do is usually just add a couple of spaces after the artist, then a vertical pipe and a couple more spaces and click save. And if we now change track name again, you should see it update. And you can see here that there is now a space and a vertical pipe between the artist name and the track name. Finally, if you also want to display the album artwork, again, just go down to the Snip icon, right click, and make sure that you have this option enabled, save album artwork, and then just make sure that in the album artwork size, you're using whichever size you want to display it, small, medium, or large. And then you come back to the Snip folder and you simply do the exact same thing. You drag across the Snip artwork onto the scene where you want it to display, and you can see this is the album art for the current track that is playing. If I skip to another song, the track name and the artist name updates, and so does the album artwork. So you can arrange that really however you want to arrange it, make it look really appealing in your stream overlay. But yeah, that's basically it. Hopefully you found this video helpful. If you have, please do give it a thumbs up. That helps more than you know. And if you can share this video with a friend that is also looking to improve their stream, I'd greatly appreciate it. I'd also recommend checking out the rest of the 2-minute tutorial series or some other videos on the Gaming Careers channel, because we upload all kinds of content helping you learn to live stream and improve your content. Thanks as always this month to the patrons that have supported the channel. If you haven't yet checked out the Gaming Careers podcast, we have now got 2 episodes live. Second episode talking to the developer of OBS. It's a really interesting story hearing about how he has built something incredibly popular for the streaming community. So definitely check that out. It's linked in the description down below, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.